This is Miss Hart's second grade class presenting Anna's frozen birthday party.
Action.
Queen Elsa was excited. Today was Princess Anna's birthday. Elsa wanted to make sure her sister's special day was perfect. Elsa used the icy powers to decorate Anna's birthday cake.
She even created a special ice decoration for the top figures of Anna and Elsa skating happily together.
Was hanging a banner across the castle courtyard.
Come check this out.
Elsa looked up to see wet paint dripping off the banner. They had started to prepare for the party very early that morning, and now time was running short.
Are you sure I can leave you in charge?
She had pushed off. Naughty Elsa, dashing away.
Keep an eye on that cake.
She called over and shouted, Elsa, tiptoe into Anna's room, gently shook her sister.
Wake up, sleepyhead, it's your birthday.
Stand up and rumble.
It's a birthday.
Back into her bed, snoring like.
My birthday, your birthday.
Elsa, you're fine.
You've never had a real birthday before, so we're going to make this an extra great.
As Anna jumped out of bed, Elsa sneezed. Just then, two tiny snowmen popped into the air, dropped to the floor, and scampered away. Neither sister noticed.
First, new dresses.
Elsa said with a wave of her hand, she created a sparkly new dress for each of them. She smiled.
And now for the presents. Laughing, the sisters followed a long string that Elsa had worn through the castle, leading Anna to different gifts. Inside a suit of armor, Anna found a bracelet.
Inside the armor, she found an oval cuckoo clock. And on a balcony, there was a
bouquet
of sunflowers. And it was a lichen.
Elsa sneaked again. The red little snowman popped into the air and tumbled to the ground. The girls still didn't notice. The snowman scurried to the courtyard where Olaf was thrilled to see them.
Little brothers!
He said proudly. Anna and Elsa followed the string all over Arendelle. Along the way, Anna discovered more presents. A family portrait, silk stockings, even a fishing pin.
Yet Elsa was sneezing more often. Each time she sneezed, more little snowmen appeared. The girls didn't spot any of them. Finally, Anna said,
"This day has been amazing, but I think we might need to go home and rest."
"No, the best is still ahead,"
Elsa insisted. She led Anna to Oaken's shop where she presented her with one of Oaken's beautiful heavy cloaks.
Oaken stepped out of the sauna and noticed Elsa's sneezing.
"How about the medical remedy of my own invention?"
Yes. He asked Anna accepted the bottle of medicine.
"I think we're going to need that."
Today is
Snowman climbing up to the cake, he grabbed Olaf's head like a bowling ball and took him.
Incoming!
Olaf said, Olaf called as he rolled into the snowman, knowing them away from the cake. Suddenly, Sven let out a panic grip. The snowman had not knocked Kristoff's birthday banner to the ground.
I'll fix it, said Olaf. I think you and the little Swedish grin smile.
All set.
But the banner wasn't quite the same as it before. There was one more gift hung at the top of the tower.
But all the rooms were overloaded with presents. And as the cold was getting worse, Anna let it with her sister.
Please, Elsa, you need to rest.
Elsa wasn't listening, though.
She was feeling feverish and she climbed the stairs to the top of the tower. It was her birthday, my best friend.
Lost her balance, Anna dropped the gifts and rushed to catch her.
Elsa, you're burning up this fever. We need to get you to bed.
I guess I have a cold.
Elsa admitted. She sighed as her sister hooked her through the castle gates.
I'm sorry, Anna. I ruined your perfect birthday.
Anna shook her head. Anything. Everything was absolutely
surprise!
Surprise!
Anna? Anna and Elsa Kristoff and Sven and Olaf were all at the courtyard, surrounded by hundreds of little snow.
Everyone saying, happy birthday! Beamed in delight. Kristoff caught up in the excitement, saying,
Kristoff.
Happy birthday, I love you, Anna.
Narrative one, read.
Then he stopped, stunned by his own outburst. Anna screamed at him. Anna was just smiling when she tucked Elsa into bed soon.
Thank you, Elsa.